Hi, let's see logical instruction set from 8051 controller. So on top of it, I explained already data transfer instruction set, arithmetic instruction set on previous videos. This is a continuation of instruction set for your 8051 controller. So logical instruction set, which talks about the standard logical operations AND, OR, XOR, NOT and left shift and right shift operations. So any programming language has to follow the same standard logical operations. Same way, assembly language also provides standard instructions to do your AND operation, OR operation, XOR operation and complement, which means NOT gate, and left shift and right shift. So this assembly language instruction set from 8051 supports the possible syntaxes between two operands. So mostly as an operand, what you are using may be registers of CPU or RAM locations 00 to 7FH and constant values as 1 byte constant values. So from these logical operations, again most of the cases your destination is accumulator. From CPU, ALU unit, all the results which allows to save in accumulator. So I will explain one by one these instructions. ANL A, RR. ANL, this is a mnemonic, and A, RR, these two are operands. ANL stands for AND logic between accumulator and any general purpose register. From 8051 CPU, there are general purpose registers from R0 to R7. You can use any general purpose register as another operand along with accumulator. And by doing logical AND operation between accumulator value and general purpose register value, your result is going to save in accumulator. This is the description. And bytes means how many opcodes it occupies from ROM memory. So for each instruction, there is an opcode from assembly language. It occupies 1 byte of ROM memory location. And cycles means machine cycles. How many machine cycles it takes to execute? So machine cycle definition is very clear. The time taken to execute an instruction is called machine cycle. From 8051, machine cycle has 3 stages: fetch, decode and execute. And from these logical operations, flags are not affected. ANL A, ADD, which means AND logic between accumulator and RAM memory addresses. You can do AND operation with accumulator and any RAM address from 00 to 7FH. Whatever the value maintained by this address, it allows to do AND operation with accumulator value and address location value. And result saved with accumulator. AND logic between accumulator and pointer register. Here RP stands for pointer registers. In 8051, as pointer registers for RAM memory, you can use R0 and R1 from indirect addressing mode. ANL A, #N, which means 1 byte constant value, you can directly take as second operand with accumulator. And AND operation, AND logic with address and accumulator. AND logic between address and constant value. So this is how your operation will allows between two operands. And CLR A, which means clear accumulator value as zeros. Whatever the value which contains, it make it as zeros. And CPL A, which is complement, which is NOT gate. The complement operation possible with only accumulator, not with any other registers or not with any other operands. ORL, which means OR logic between accumulator and general purpose registers, which are R0 to R7. And OR logic between accumulator and address locations. OR logic between accumulator and pointer register, and result saved in accumulator. OR logic between A and constant value. Hash in means one byte constant value. And OR logic between address and A. OR logic between address and constant value. This is your XRL, which means XOR logic between A and register. XOR logic between A and address location. XOR logic between A and pointer register. XOR logic between A and constant value. XOR logic address with A. XOR logic address with constant value. And NOP, which is no operation. It just simply increments your ROM location by one address, which is program counter incremented by one location. RL, which is rotate left, equivalent to left shift operator from C language. Rotate left, accumulator value. Rotate left through carry. I'll explain in detail in the same video. And rotate right, accumulator value. Rotate right through carry, accumulator value. Even your shift operations allows with only accumulator, not with any other operands. And swap means LSB part will become MSB part of given number and MSB part will become LSB part of your given number. Swap means. So this is your information about operands. RR means R0 to R7 registers and pointer register as R0 and R1. ADD means RAM addresses from 00 to 7FH and hash in, which is 1 byte constant value. So this is your standard logic gates truth table. If you are trying to do AND operation between two binary bits D0 and D1, AND operation answer is 0, 01 also 0, 10 also 0, for 11 only output is 1. The same thing for OR gate, 00 is 0, 01 is 1 and 10 combination is 1 output and 11 combination is also 1 output. For XOR gate, both inputs are same, output is 0. Means 00 also 0, 11 also 0. For 01 and 10 combination, output is high in the case of XOR gate. And NOT gate is the complement of your input. So let's see these operations with some examples. I'm trying to masking only LSB bits of given number. So I took 98 is 1 my input number. The expected output is 90H. Means whatever the number we are trying to mask, I need to mask only LSB part, not complete number. So whatever the number they are giving, only LSB as to 0. Remaining MSB remains same. Further, just see what I am doing. The 98H BCD equivalent is 1001 and 8 equivalent is 1000. I am trying to do AND operation with F0. If you are trying to do AND operation with F0 with any number, LSB part becomes 0, MSB part remains same. So this is how I am trying to do this masking LSB bits of given number. If suppose you are trying to make it logic 0 on specific bit, maybe D0, maybe D4, maybe D5, you have to make it 0 at that position and remaining all are 1s. If you do AND operation, you are going to make it only that particular bit as 0. Remaining all are same. No change from the other bits. So that's also you can work out with program. The second example is complementing MSB part of given number. So complementing means make it zeros as 1s and 1s as zeros of only MSB part. LSB part remains same. So I am taking 56 is the number. For 56, BCD equivalent is 01010110 and expected output is A6H. So 5 complement is A. So I am trying to do XOR operation with F0H. So if you are applying XOR operation with F0H, so you will get 10100110. So that's my answer. So this is how a program you can write with assembly language. Move A, hash 90H is the first number I am taking into A Now I am trying to do AND logic with accumulator and F0H. If any value started with character, then you need to write 0 before, so that it doesn't treat it as a hexadecimal number F, not regular character F. So even for XOR operation, that value I am taking into A and XOR logic with F0. And the other example is, I am taking two different numbers in A and B and trying to do all logical operations, AND operation with A and B, but your result will saved in accumulator, so that again you have to reassign the number with the A and trying to do OR operation with AB, and again reassigning the first number into A, XOR operation with A and reassigning the value to A, and complement operation AND. So if you want to check the output of these programs, you need to use the Skill Microvision IDE. So this is one popular IDE to write the programs, to compile the programs, to debug the programs, and to create .hex files for your assembly language programs or embedded C programs. So now I will show you the steps related to the Skill Microvision. Just choose the project tab and select the option New Microvision Project. And know where you are trying to save this project. I just selected D drive and ASM folder. Now I am giving my project name as Logical. Give the project name and click on Save button. Now this shows the window for choosing microcontroller, for which microcontroller you are trying to write programs. So this Skill Microvision supports for all different manufacturers. So there are many number of manufacturers that are using this Skill Microvision IDE to develop the programs. So from this list, you need to choose one specific device. I am just selecting Atmel manufacturer. Don't think that Keel is applicable for only Atmel. There are many manufacturers. You can develop programs for all these devices, including Philips, Samsung, Motorola, Honeywell. There are many manufacturers. You can use this Skill Microvision IDE. Select your manufacturer and click on plus mark. It will show the list of devices from this manufacturer. So from this list, I am going to select specific device, which is AT89C51, and click on OK. So now it will show you startup code warning. The startup code which maintains all the default values of registers. If you want to click add this startup code with your existence project, click on yes, otherwise no. So there is no problem, I'll go with yes or no option. Now I'm proceeding with no. Up to now, you decided your microcontroller, for which microcontroller you want to start write programs. Now to write the program, you need to open editor window. Further, go file tab and choose option new. This is the text editor. Here you can type your program. And you can do AND operation AND logic with A with F0H. This is one simple program. Now, after writing program on text editor, you need to save. Further, go file tab again and choose option save. So I just saving this program with the name AND logic. It requires extension of your language. So you written program in assembly language, so you need to save this program with .asm extension. Give the name followed by .asm and click on save button. Now this program has to compile with respect to target. Just select your target one, click on plus mark, and get source group 1. Now right click on the source group 1. So you need to add the source code with this existence target. But it will show you default C source files, you need to change it to ASM. So what is my program and logic? So I am just selecting this file, click on add button and close it. You can cross check whether program is added or not. Now my program is added with my target. To check errors and warnings of this program, go project tab and choose the option build target. So it will show you errors and warnings present in the program. Now I want to cross check my output whether I am getting 90H or not. Further, go debug tab and choose the option start or stop debug session. So it will show you one warning because of this limited version for 2K size. Click on OK, there is no issue. So this is your disassembly window, which tells the opcode, equivalent opcodes of your instructions also. You can watch it here. Now to execute this program line by line, you can press F11 function key from the keyboard. Now the value, I got it into 98. After pressing F11 again, the value became 90H. So this is a way to cross check your outputs by entering into debug mode. So still, if you are trying to press F11, no lines to execute. So if you want to stop this debug session, again go with the same option, debug tab, and use the same button, stop debug session. So even if you want to test other programs, you can remove this file from source group and you can go with a new file just by going with the file option. So I am just testing my complement logic 56H. I am using this XRL operation A with F0H. So again, go file tab and save this file with specific extension XOR logic. But for program always, extension is required, which is .asm. And the file, you can add it here. And build. This is a build shortcut button. Now what is your expected output? A6H from accumulator. Enter into debug mode and to execute this program, use function key F11. Now you got 56H in accumulator. After executing this XRL operation, the value will become A6H. So still, if you are applying F11 function key, no lines to execute. This is how you can cross-check your outputs by using this Scale Microvision IDE. So this is your rotate operations in assembly language. Whereas there are five operations from instruction set: rotate left, rotate right, and rotate left through carry, rotate right through carry. First you will see rotate left operation. So whereas 8 individual bits of accumulator value. So rotate left means each bit shifted left side once, but the most significant bit will reach to D0 position after rotate left. Whereas rotate right is opposite, D7 will become D6, D6 will become D5, D4 will become D5 will become D4, D4 will become D3, and D3 become D2, D2 become D1, D1 become D0. And D0 bit is moved to D7 position in the case of rotate right. The difference between rotate left through carry is D7 is not directly moving to D0 position. D7 bit is moved to carry logic, and whatever the carry logic, which is moved to D0 position. So that happens in the case of rotate left through carry. And in the case of rotate right through carry, your D0 doesn't move to D7 directly. So D0 logic is moved to carry logic and carry logic is forwarded to D7 logic. This is how your rotate right through carry works. So for more videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube. erratic solutions and give your valuable feedback as comment. Please share and like our videos. And you are working on different levels of embedded system skill set. You are working on firmware, IoT and device drivers. So you keep on sharing the videos on these three highly required topics for all embedded developers. We are providing training on these three levels, on classroom training and online, and we'll give projects on these different levels on protocols, microcontrollers and wireless modules, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GSM, GPS, and with three languages of embedded: assembly, embedded C and Python. Even we are working on operating system concepts, system programming, network programming. If anyone is looking for development and training related activities, please call back with this number 9676327118. If anyone wants to reach our office, please follow this address: Rajamma Towers, Jayanagar, Bhagyanagar Colony, near KPHB Metro Station, Kukatpalli, Hyderabad. Any queries, please write an email ysnanda@erratechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.